What's up, guys? I'm just doing a quick prog review on the levitating UFO speaker. So sorry I'm so low to the ground. I'm trying to actually just angle myself in here so we can get a shot of everything. But this is the UFO levitating speaker itself. So just to give you guys an idea real quick, you'll obviously be getting a charging wire. You'll be getting a base, and you'll be getting your UFO. So just to give you guys an idea on the quality, it's actually really nice. It's a metal UFO. The base is some kind of metal. It's coated in some kind of matte black finish, which is really nice. They give you all different modes on how to control the lights here. So you have obviously this white LED finish, and you have all these color changing LEDs on top. So those color changing LEDs go to all different colors, blue, yellow, green, orange, red, the whole rainbow. So it's really cool too as a display. So you have this little touch button here, and when you click that, you obviously see that the LED is shut off. So that's the first mode. The second mode shuts off the white LEDs on the bottom, but turns on the colored LEDs on top. And if you hit it one more time, it turns everything back on. Now guys, you do have another button on top of here too. That controls this Bluetooth speaker. So if you click that, you'll hear it turn on. If you hit it one more time, that's its shut off noise. Guys, just to let you know, when you plug everything in, getting this UFO to center is not the easiest thing in the world. It does take a couple times to actually do it. In order to actually do it, you do need to place it in the actual center. It's either you place it in the center and let it rise up, or you got to place it in the center and kind of steadily circle it around until it starts to center point itself. Do not ever try and put it on its sides, or it will push itself all over the place. We may try to do a video just to show you guys how that works. It does take at least 5-10 minutes to actually get this to work properly. It's not an easy thing. The next thing I want to go over is also the Bluetooth speaker. We will do a little video on that real quick just to show you what it sounds like, its quality wise. And you can take the UFO with you also. You can stick it in your pocket and walk around and play music with it. So it doesn't just have to stay on that little levitating base. So guys, this is the UFO levitating speaker. I hope this video gave you guys an idea of how it works and what it looks like. And have a nice day.
All right, guys, so this is the demonstration video for the UFO being placed on there. So what I recommend is you don't place it on its sides. Definitely just place it right in the middle. That's your best way to actually get it to balance. And once you get a good feel for it, let it go and it should start floating right on its own. So let's give this a try. And you may see me struggle a little bit. I never get it the first time. It takes a couple tries and eventually you will get it perfect. And what you're hearing is the Bluetooth going on and off, and that's just because it's being replaced onto the base itself. And there we go. Okay, so that's it itself, and you can have it spinning. As long as it's sitting on the platform, just don't tap it at all. If you tap it and it wiggles, it may actually fall off of its base. All right, guys, so this is the UFO, and we're going to do now a sound test with it. So we're going to start it off pretty low and bring it up right on up. My thing, but it's been awfully exhausting. Songs as long as daunting, which caused me to have to make a call I thought was ballsy, resulting in what you see today. Proceed indulging as always. The one trick pony's here, so quit your sulking. Born efficient, got ambition, sort of vicious. Yep, that's me. Not artistic, unrealistic, chauvinistic, not those things. Go the distance, so prolific, postal cryptic, move swiftly, unsubmissive, the king of mischief, the golden ticket, rare sight to see. I stay committed, embrace the rigid, I'm playful with it, yeah, basically, too great to mimic, you hate your bitter, no favoritism, that's fine with me. Create the riddles, portrayed and civil, unsafe a little, oh yes indeed, it's plain and simple. Alright guys, I hope that gave you an idea of how it sounded, and have a nice day.